Hi, my name is Lacey Smith, and I am a CVI project coordinator at the CVI Center at Perkins School for the Blind. And today in this video, we'll be talking about the impact of light. What is the impact of light? All vision depends on light. Light can either increase or decrease visual attention and recognition. Some individuals with CVI require light to establish and maintain visual attention. Recognition may also be dependent on light. Other individuals with CVI may demonstrate photophobia, avoiding light sources and fatiguing quickly when presented with lighted presentations. There's a photo of a caregiver looking over a child in a wheelchair with a lighted background by Ryan Beckman. What does the research say? The retinal photoreceptors convert light energy into electrical impulses, which are transmitted to the visual cortex, where primary processing takes place for visual acuity, color, contrast sensitivity, and visual fields. Some individuals with CVI flick their fingers in front of the light source, or blink excessively, or gaze at flickering fires, or stare at spinning fans. Individuals who have eye teeming and/or eye movement disorders may experience light sensitivity. Strabismus and nystagmus are coexisting impairments commonly found in individuals with CVI. In this photo, you'll see a teenage boy with a sparkler on a dark night. Children with CVI may be involuntarily drawn to light. This may include primary sources of light, such as lamps and overhead lights, lights from the window or sun, backlit displays including iPads, TVs, monitors, and phones, and even glare on the surface. Some individuals with CVI may only be attracted to lighted items. They might need objects brightly illuminated. They might need competing light sources removed. They might seek out the brightest target in the room. They might not be able to see an object if others around it are equally lit. And they may easily attend to and recognize visual information presented on a backlit device. In this photo is a young boy with a light box with clear colored shapes on the surface. Some individuals with CVI may demonstrate light sensitivity. They may avoid looking at and turn away from light sources, squint excessively, have difficulty transitioning from dark to bright environments, navigate with their heads down, become visually fatigued from using lighted materials, have significant difficulty traveling outdoors on sunny or snowy days. Some environmental considerations to consider might include having controllable artificial lighting such as dimmers, bank lighting, lamps, having controllable natural lighting, shades or curtains, dark rugs to absorb glare, and seating that allows the individual with CVI to face away from the light sources. In this photo, a young boy sits in a supported seat facing a tri-wall board using an AAC device on the table and a larger backlit screen during an educational activity. In this photo, a young boy with CVI who also has photophobia is wearing his sunglasses as he sits in his wheelchair stroller on a sunny day. Some materials or personal equipment may include brimmed hats, wraparound sunglasses, and/or transition lenses, options for adjustable task lighting and/or backlighting, materials that use matte finish, high contrast material presentation. Here's an example of a young boy looking at the lights on the brim of his hat. The first objects he might attend to are objects that produce their own light. His goal might be to help him notice and fixate on a specific light, providing him opportunities to control his eye movement and interact with a shared experience. He may be interested in lights, but not illuminated objects yet. Here's another example of impact of light. In this photo, there's a young boy using a backlit device to support his writing skills. The backlighting provided by the display makes the task easier than it would be if completed on paper. Room lighting is still present, but not distracting from the activity. The illuminated letters are comparatively brighter than anything else in the student's view and easier to attend to. Here's a quote from a parent of a child with CVI. "There are specific indoor lights that my daughter does not prefer to have on. In her bedroom, she prefers a daylight color temperature bulb to be on as opposed to the overhead ceiling light. She uses this projected light from her desk lamp as a spotlight and does not want it directly on her." And here's a quote from an adult with CVI. "When I read, I need to have a lot of light in the room and have frequent breaks in between, especially when I'm reading school books." Here is some current research supporting the impact of light. Every child with CVI is teachable, and every child has a right to a meaningful and accessible education. For more information, please visit perkins.org/CVI or cvinow.org.